Did you know that trilobites survived 20 plus mass extinction events throughout their nearly 300 million year time range? The only thing that finally did cause their extinction was the largest mass extinction event of all time. So why were they so dang successful? And what finally made them go extinct? So first things first, trilobites, if you don't know what they were marine arthropods with incredible diversity and obviously endurance as they survived many mass extinction events. They evolved during the Cambrian explosion of animal life around 540 million years ago and went extinct at the Permian-Triassic boundary around 250 million years ago during the largest mass extinction event of all time called the Great Dying. If you want to know about their classification and physiological characteristics, I talk a lot more about that in my other trilobite video, which I'll link up to the top right for you. But in this video, I will be focusing kind of on their success, what factors led to their success, and what factors finally caused their extinction, and kind of their evolutionary timeline on which they went extinct and which extinction events had the biggest impacts. Their first several million years were great within the Cambrian explosion because it provided kind of the perfect backdrop for them to flourish and diversify. But then, like I mentioned, throughout the Paleozoic era during which they lived, they had to endure 20 plus mass extinction events, two of which are included in the Big Five mass extinctions that we kind of recognize as the major mass extinction events of Earth's history. But when exactly were each of these events? What caused them, and more importantly, how the heck did trilobites survive all that? The first major extinction events that the trilobites had to endure were within the Cambrian period itself. There were kind of a lot of extinction events in the Cambrian because animals themselves were newly evolved, trying to kind of figure out which body forms worked the best. More things were evolving, the same body forms that did better, and then the other one, the one that didn't do as well, went extinct. There was a lot of competition. There was a lot of biologically caused mass extinction events rather than like climate change caused or asteroid impact caused mass extinction events. So it was a time of, you know, increased extinction rate, which is to be expected. But even so, trilobites as a whole survived all of these extinction events in the Cambrian, even though they did have to suffer some loss with the red liquid and olenellid trilobites going extinct around 497 million years ago during the Dresbachian extinction event. There were then three Silurian extinction events, and I'm realizing right at this moment right now that I misnumbered these. Silurian comes after the Ordovician. I'm stupid. I put the Ordovician one next, so just keep in mind there was, you know, the late Ordovician mass extinction event, which is one of the big five mass extinction events of Earth's history, that happened around 445 million years ago due to, well, a lot of factors, but one of them was killer moss, which is pretty cool. And I have a video about that extinction event. If you want to check it out, I'll link it to the top right. But after that were the Silurian extinction events. There were three. They weren't part of the big five. They were relatively minor events, but they did heavily affect some groups of trilobites. Yet, trilobites still were going strong, even after the Ordovician and Silurian extinction events. And then in the Devonian, which is perhaps like the most extinction-heavy period of all time, there were 9 Devonian ocean anoxic events, or ocean hypoxic events, basically when deep marine waters, or in some extreme cases, even some shallow parts of the ocean, go anoxic, or they basically decrease in oxygen levels or completely become like no oxygen, anoxic, which makes, you know, animal life have a hard time because animals need oxygen to breathe and live, even aquatic ones. So this would have caused the major extinctions of many marine organisms throughout the Devonian period. But the late Devonian extinction event, which is also called the Frasnian-Framinian event, I believe, occurred around 370 million years ago and is included in the big five mass extinctions in Earth's history, heavily affected trilobites. And actually, it was this event that probably set them on the path for extinction later at the end of the Permian, but they still survived the Mississippian Pennsylvanian or mid-Carboniferous event called the Serpukhovian extinction event, or major ice age that caused a mass extinction at that time. And then they got all the way to the end of the Permian period, the end of the Paleozoic era, around 250 million years ago, when the Great Dying occurred, the largest mass extinction of all time, and that took out the remaining trilobites. So just to show kind of their abundance and diversity through the Paleozoic era, so we can better see how each of these extinction events affected trilobites, we see here that the earliest trilobites, the red lichids and olenellids, evolved during the Cambrian explosion. And then we had three more orders of trilobites. So just some background here. An order is kind of just a big taxonomical group that's bigger than species, genus, and family? Or is family bigger? I don't know. An order is a group, a taxonomic group of organisms. And so these names you see on the screen are orders, groups of types of trilobites. So the Agnostida, Tychoperida, and Corynexicida trilobite orders also evolved in the Cambrian period. Then we had the red lichid and olenellid extinctions. Then in the Ordovician, we got many more groups, specifically the trinucleids, acephids, phacopods, and lichids dominated. And then unfortunately, the end Ordovician mass extinction event caused the agnostids, tychoperids, corynexicids, acephids, and lichids to go extinct. And then the trinucleids went extinct at the end of the Silurian. And then in the Devonian, the phacopods, proetids, and lichids were dominant. And then at the end, or kind of late in the Devonian period, all orders of trilobites went extinct except the proetids. And so this is just showing how drastic the Devonian period was for trilobites, how drastic these extinction events in the Devonian were. I mean, even the phacopods underwent decline before the late Devonian, which was then, you know, one of the major extinction events. And then at the very end Devonian, there was another one. So some of these trilobites went extinct at the late Devonian extinction with this line here, and some continued to the very end of the Devonian, but then went extinct. So there was just event after event, and they tried to survive, and then there's another event, and it's like, how can you survive that? And one of the major things, other than the anoxia, the low oxygen levels at the time that might have contributed to their declines during this time, was that this was the age of fish. The Devonian is nicknamed the age of fish because fish, you know, they evolved before the Devonian, but they really came to dominate seas and become kind of apex predators during the Devonian. And because jawed fish had evolved by then, you know, trilobites with their hard exoskeletons, they had this protection from, you know, less able predators, but with jaws around and bigger fish and bigger mouths to swallow them and crunch them up, they really didn't stand a chance. Or, you know, the only ones that really did were probably the ones that could swim away quickly or burrow. And so it was good that trilobites had this diversity, which enabled them to survive so much predation and extinction events, but, you know, eventually caught up to them. And these declines, with both biological pressure and major climate changes in the Devonian, caused them to basically just have this one little tiny group straggle on until the very end of the Permian. And these proetids then went extinct at the end Permian, mass extinction event, the greatest extinction event of all time. But it has been suggested that trilobites did survive into the Triassic right after that Great Dying event. But this is based on trace fossils that could be produced by other organisms. I think they're based on fossilized burrows. So it's not fully known whether this is true evidence of trilobites surviving past that extinction event or not. But even if they did survive, it wouldn't have been for long because, surprise, surprise, there were three more consecutive extinction events right after the Great Dying in the early Triassic period, just kind of because the world was so unstable after that major climatic and biological event. I talk more about all these extinction events in my Extinction Events Nobody Talks About video, which I'll link to the top right if you want to check it out. So what factors led to their extreme success and longevity? Well, their ecological diversity, in other words, their ability to adapt to many different environments like shallow coasts, deep sea, seafloor, and even the open ocean, really played a big role in their success. It also greatly increased their chances of surviving environmental changes and mass extinction events because it allowed them to exploit diverse food sources and environments. Their segmented bodies also played a role as it allowed flexibility and efficient locomotion, which helped them to kind of get away from predators when needed or catch prey. Many species of trilobites also had very complex and sophisticated eyes, giving them really great vision to detect predators or prey. In addition, they developed various types of spines, specialized appendages, and diverse forms of segmentation, as well as the ability to kind of roll up, kind of like modern day pill bugs or roly polies, to protect themselves or defend themselves from predators or, you know, even environmental changes. They also had a really high reproductive output. In other words, they laid a large amount of eggs, ensuring the survival of at least some of their offspring. This helped them to survive and recover after mass extinction events. They also exhibited diverse reproductive strategies, which helped them to maintain and expand their populations. And their wide geographic distribution and short generation times allowed for rapid adaptation and recovery after extinction events, many of which they had to endure. They also experienced relatively low competition. Since marine ecosystems at the time the trilobites were evolving in the early Cambrian were much less crowded. Animals were just evolving, just diversifying in this explosion of life. And so trilobites had this chance to get in early on this prime ecological role that they filled that was really diverse as well, providing them with ample resources and opportunities for, you know, roles to play as well as food to eat. Geology was also relatively stable at the time. It was kind of between supercontinents. You had Rodinia breakup right before the Ediacaran and Cambrian, and then you had Pangaea form in the Permian, which contributed to that major mass extinction event that took them out. And in between this, you were kind of in between supercontinents. And yes, things were shifting around tectonically, but in general, you had a relatively stable presence of many shallow seas along many of these continental land masses, allowing for a lot of different ecological, environmental, you know, area for trilobites to live, and just marine ecosystems as a whole. Major tectonic and extinction events were actually also less frequent during the early Paleozoic than the latter half, which is likely something that contributed to the fact that trilobites were much more successful in the early half of the Paleozoic. So those were all the factors that led to their success, but what factors finally led to the trilobites' extinction? Well, again, the Great Dying is when they finally went extinct around 252 million years ago. However, it was likely the events leading up to this, like we talked about, like the Devonian ones, that really set them on the path for extinction. Trilobites significantly declined before the Permian event, especially in the late and end Devonian extinctions. The Devonian extinctions really hit trilobites different, and they really didn't recover afterwards. Instead, only one order of trilobites, the Proeidids, hung on until the end Permian. It's almost like Voldemort and his Horcruxes. Basically, all the Horcrux trilobites were gone after the Devonian, and all that was left was Proeidids, Voldemort himself, and it was relatively easy to kill off the Proeidids after all of its other forms were dead. But with how many extinction events they did survive and recover from, why didn't they recover after the Devonian extinctions? Well, many factors probably led to them being hit harder in the Devonian and not recovering after, including sea level shifts, glaciation events, changes in ocean chemistry, just general environmental and climatic changes that probably disrupted trilobite habitats and food distribution. And competition was a main thing as well. So after these environmental changes, you know, got to them and caused them to decline, it was probably harder for them to recover because competition from newly evolved and diversifying organisms at the time really might have taken over their spot or taken over the spot of apex predator and kind of jaw-crunching type life that might have just crunched their way right through all the trilobites that tried to recover. Advanced predators, including fish that evolved in the age of fish and really advanced and diversified, and cephalopods also exerted pressure on trilobites, making survival a lot more challenging. But even though they did eventually go extinct, trilobites were potentially the most successful group of animals ever. I mean, they dominated for a remarkably long time from 300 or nearly 300 million years, which not a lot of groups of animals can claim. Not only this, but they occupied a wide range of ecological niches and displayed an incredible variety of body forms and adaptations. They weren't just hiding in some corner surviving all the extinction events because they weren't, you know, out there. They were out there, they were everywhere, and they still survived for so long. But with this in mind, other animals like insects, also arthropods, have also shown incredible diversity, abundance, and ecological impact, and could claim the title of most successful animal ever if we're going by these parameters. So I guess it kind of depends on how we define success. What parameters are we going by exactly? In terms of longevity and diversity, trilobites, as well as insects, are up there. They're in the ranking, for sure. But if you go by advanced capabilities, intelligence, and technology, you know, humans are number one. So it does kind of depend on how we define success, but if we go by longevity, then it'll definitely be trilobites, because I don't think that humans are going to last 300 million years. If you want to check out a video about another really interesting Paleozoic arthropod that got up to 2 meters in length and was the first apex predator on Earth, I will link that video up for you here. And with that, guys, my references are always linked down below, and I can't wait to see you guys next time. Bye!